Welcome, students. Now I'm going to explain some aspects related to the use of models to express future possibility and conclusions. To express future possibility, we can use the models may, might, or could. Okay. You can use may not and might not to express the possibility that something will not happen. For example, he has good intentions, but he might not solve the problems. Él tiene buenas intenciones, pero puede que no resuelva los problemas. Okay. So in this case, I am expressing that the possibility that something will not happen. In the case of this example, I am expressing the possibility that the possibility that he could not solve the problems, okay? Estoy expresando la posibilidad de que él no podría resolver los problemas. Use couldn't to express the idea that something is impossible. You can see a dialogue between two people. Why don't you cut class tomorrow? I couldn't do that. I have to give a presentation. Entonces dice, ¿por qué no falta clase mañana? Y la respuesta es, no podría hacer eso. Tengo que dar una presentación. Okay, so in this case, the person B is expressing impossibility. Okay, that it is impossible that he or she can cut class tomorrow. Questions about possibility usually do not use may, might, or could. Okay, instead, they use the future, will be going to, or the present progressing. Or phrases such as do you think, or is it possible that? You can see these examples here. Do you think that it will rain tomorrow too? Okay. In this case, I am using the expression do you think. Yeah, but in this case, in the answers, I can use the model. It could stop tonight. Okay. So the answers to these questions often use may, might, or could. Okay. So in summary, you don't usually use may, might, or could for questions. Okay. It is better to use it in answers. Yeah. Now about models for conclusions. The models for expressing conclusions include must, have, to, have got to, may, might, could, and can't. Okay. When we are almost 100% certain, we use must, have to, or have got to state affirmative conclusions. You can see in this chart a comparison between the fact and the conclusion. In the first case, the fact is that Wilson has only one clerk. Okay. So the conclusion that I draw from this example is that, well, his shop must be quite small. Okay. When I use must be in this case, I am almost 100% certain that the shop is small. Okay, so let me explain in Spanish. En primer caso, tenemos un hecho y una conclusión. El hecho es que Wilson tiene solamente un cliente. Y lo que concluye es que su almacén debe ser bastante pequeño. Entonces, en este caso, estoy casi 100% seguro que el almacén es pequeño, ¿no? Porque estoy utilizando el modal must. So, entonces, en estos casos, puedo utilizar los modales must, have to, or have got to, para expresar que estoy casi 100% seguro de lo que digo. The second case, you can see Wilson applied for a job. He has to need money. They pay men for debating with the president. It's gotta be a joke. So, in these cases of these conclusions, I am 100% certain of these conclusions. And when we are less certain about our conclusion, we use may, might, or could to express that something is possible. Okay. En estos casos, cuando estamos no estamos tan seguros de nuestra conclusión, podemos utilizar may, might, or could. Yeah. You can see the facts and the conclusion. His hand is swollen. He may write a lot. Dice que su mano está inflamada, ¿no? Está hinchada. La conclusión es que él puede que él escriba mucho, ¿no? Entonces, cuando digo, utilizo esta conclusión con may, quiere decir que no estoy muy seguro de esto. Yeah. Watson knows a lot about medicine. He might be a doctor. Okay, the same thing. I'm not certain, not too certain about this conclusion. Vincent knows a lot about cameras. He could be a photographer. Okay, so in this case, the person is not too certain that the Vincent is a photographer. To express negative conclusions, we can use can't or couldn't when we are almost 100% certain that something is impossible. He can't be dead. I just saw him. O sea, él no puede estar muerto. Acabo de verlo. Quiere decir que está casi 100% seguro de que él no está muerto o que de la persona no está muerta, ¿no? Porque estoy utilizando can't. Yeah. Use must not when you are slightly less certain. Cuando se está menos seguro de que algo es imposible, se utiliza must not. He must not have enough money. He never buys new clothes. Dice, él no debe tener mucho dinero. Nunca compra ropa nueva. En este caso, no estoy tan seguro de que esto sea imposible, ¿no? Okay. We use may not and might not when you are even less certain. Cuando estemos incluso menos seguros, casi no muy seguros, podemos usar may not and might not. He may not know about the plan. His boss doesn't tell him everything. Él puede que no sepa acerca del plan, ¿no? Su jefe no le dice todo. Okay, en este caso no estamos muy seguros, o que estamos poco seguros de lo que decimos. Do not use have to and have got to draw negative conclusions. Okay. So in this case, the correct form is it can be true. In the incorrect form, it doesn't have to be true. Okay. You can see the difference in meaning here. If I say it doesn't have to be true, no, no tiene que ser verdad. Estoy diciendo que no necesariamente tiene que ser verdad. Que es verdad. Entonces, no es exactamente una conclusión. Pero si digo no puede ser verdad, en este caso, sí estoy expresando seguridad en la conclusión. Okay, so that's all I can say about the models for expressing future possibility and conclusions. Thank you very much.